Yo, what's up? Today is a special day. Today's the day that I hit a puzzle rating of 3,000 on chess.com. Now, I know what you're thinking. Chris, shouldn't you be talking to girls or something? And yeah, maybe I should be, but today I'm going for a different type of queen. Get it? Like, queen? Get it? Like chess? No?
Okay.
Okay, anyways, I'm currently at 2,900 plus, so today I'm going to try to hit 3,000. Let's take a look at my history real quick. Okay, so let's go to stats, so puzzles. Time. So yeah, you can see I started around 2014. I was around like, I don't know, like 1,400 to 1,700. And then you see this like giant plateau. This is when I went to college. So I took a huge break from chess. Yeah, that's when my rating plateaued. Starting the, you know, sneaky link era, so obviously didn't have much time for chess. Anyways, now I recently got back into it around 2020, 2019, and so I've climbed all the way to 2,900. I'm currently at this rating right now. Alright, so real quick, now huge disclaimer, you know, hitting 3,000 in chess puzzles doesn't mean that, you know, I'm good at chess. My over-the-board ELO is like 1,400, and honestly, I don't really know any theory. I just really like doing puzzles and I do them every day as part of my morning routine. You know, even our girl Beth Harmon, you know, from Queen's Gambit from Netflix, doesn't really think chess puzzles are, you know, super relevant. Here's a clip from Queen's Gambit, which I watched, you know, kind of recently, regarding chess puzzles that I remember. So let's watch it real quick.
Do you do problems?
No.
Never.
I always found them irrelevant. Positions that never come up in actual games.
Yeah, so irrelevant and problems that don't ever show up in real games, so I don't know, I mean, maybe chess puzzles aren't that awesome, but anyways, I really like doing them. I think they're fun for, you know, like tactics and practice, but yeah, just because you're good at it doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, you're gonna be like a great player. But yeah, anyways, today I'm gonna try to hit 3,000, which I think is a really cool milestone for me. So these puzzles right now that I'm about to do are definitely considered, you know, grandmaster level puzzles. And honestly, some of these around this level get really, really wonky, like requires some like really in-depth calculations, you know, so feel free to pause the video and follow along with me. I'm definitely not going to get all of them right, but I'm going to try to hit 3,000 because I'm so close and I think I can do it. And yeah, I hope you find amusement in, you know, my brain exploding and suffering from trying to hit this milestone, and I hope you enjoy. All right, let's begin. Okay, so right off the bat, we're down in exchange and we're down a pawn, so it's not looking good. I see this check over here. Looks really appealing. It's pretty forced. He has to go here. Take, take. Queen comes in. I don't know. It doesn't really look... We also have this knight fork, which is pretty good. I really do like the rook check first, but after block, not really sure if I see a follow-up after... takes, takes, queen to g6 to check. Yeah, I mean, I can bring my knight here, but this fork seems kind of weak though. Like, queen here. I don't know. It's definitely one of these moves. It's either this or this, I think. There's not really anything else to do. Check, block, knight here. I don't like that. Even, what about here? And I take this, and then you start checking me. Go here. I mean, I don't know. Rook. Check here. I mean, that seems the most forceful, though. Like, there's just so many things I feel like you can do after knight. Knight f5. Even here, I'm not really certain. I think rook check is more certain, so I'm gonna try rook check actually. Okay, nice, it's right. I mean, it has to be takes, right? Maybe it's take, take, you bring your queen in, then you bring your knight in, and then maybe it's just too deadly. Surely it's not knight first. Take, take, check. Just doesn't seem like it's good enough. What about queen there? It's kind of a weird move. Actually, queen there is kind of a really funny move. Because you can't take. That's actually kind of hilarious. Queen here. Take, check. You can't go here because of this fork, so you go here. Queen check. Back. I mean, it's starting to look unpleasant. Let's go for it. Okay. I really... Should I just go here? Wow. Sack your queen. Interesting that there's a right way to take. Really? I feel like taking any way wins, does it not? Oh, we can't take this way because of this check. What's wrong with this take, though? Oh, no, you can't take that way either. You gotta take with the pawn. Wow, that's a 3,000 puzzle. Jeez. I think that's the highest puzzle I've ever done. Alright, let's continue. Oh my god, we don't even have a queen. Okay. What's the material count? We have a rook and a minor piece for a queen, and we're also down 3 pawns. So, we need to go for the kill here. So obviously this check is interesting, because it looks really forceful. Like, the king has to go here. Because if it goes here, we have discovered checks, and it's really unpleasant. The problem is after bishop takes f2, king h1. I mean, white has a threat over here. And after takes... I don't know. So, I mean, we have to respond to this immediately, right? Because otherwise we're going to get sauced on e7. I really think bishop takes f2 is like our only option. I mean, I don't really see any other move. Everything else looks like it loses. Bishop takes f2, it is. Okay, so the king moved to h1 as we expected. We still have to answer to this threat. I mean, we could just take the rook. And after queen takes, I just don't know what the next move is. Maybe it's rook here, because we're threatening this, and that looks pretty hard to defend. Alright, so bishop takes, queen takes, rook here, I think is pretty interesting. Or maybe even rook here is pretty interesting. But the knight can block. Oh, maybe that's the wrong one. That's gotta be right. Okay, so like we said, rook to f2 is no good. So what about this one? This one's more interesting because we're threatening this, and that looks really, really hard to defend. You have this spite check, but I can just pivot, and then I don't see anything. How do you stop this? I don't see a way to stop it. Oh my goodness. That was a 2800 puzzle. We're almost there, guys. Whew. One more. Or maybe two more, depending on how long it takes. Alright. White to move. In these type of positions, the king is like hanging on to this rook for dear life, right? The one on c5. So, this check is forced. It pushes the king to c4. And then we're gonna move our knights to one of these squares to cover this square to push him away again. So he's probably gonna be forced to even run this way. So, I mean, this has to be it. The question is, which one of these knight moves is better? And this is the part where we have to figure out, like, the route the knight takes eventually. So, this check, he can't go here, because I take, he takes, and then I run. Wait, he runs, I go here, he takes, I take, and that's lost for him. So he can't, if I check him here, he has to go here. See, the problem is, after he goes here, I don't know what to do, because I have this check, and he can go back. No, he can't go back because I have this check. Okay, so let's do that again. Check. Here. Check. Here. And I lose. Okay, so let's try this one. Check. Here. Check. Here. Check. And you lose. But what happens after check here? Check here. I don't see it. Is it really this one? But after here. I don't get it.
Oh my god.
It's so close. I can taste it. Which one of these night moves is it? Am I stupid? This one, okay, look, check. He can't go here. He can't go here. Can't go here. So he has to go here, okay? So check, he goes here. I check him again. He goes here. I check him again. He takes, and then I lose. So it can't be this. So it has to be this. But why? See, the only thing that I can't calculate is if I check, he goes here. I check, he goes here. I have nothing. Right? I'm gonna do it. I don't know if it's right. Oh! Why? Why is that wrong? So check, here, here. I saw this. What the heck? Oh my god, what is this puzzle? What is that? The rook's trapped? What kind of puzzle is this? Oh my goodness. Alright, well, can't win them all. White to move. So, Tyrael's even, but we have a huge threat of this guy promoting soon. So the funny thing is, if I put my rook here, and he takes, and I take, and he takes, and I push, isn't he lost? Alright, rook here, with the idea that if he takes, I don't even take with the knight, because that looks like kind of, that still kind of looks drawish. Rook here, rook takes, pawn takes. Yeah, that's so funny. So this is the tricky part. I don't think you can take with the knight. I think you take with the pawn. And you can't catch this. Now I push. Alright, there's no tricks. Turn to a queen. Nice. Okay, I mean, come on, there's gotta be a mate here, right? So many dark square weaknesses. So, check here. Bishop here, and he's lost. Queen? Yeah, wait, what's the gig here? How do you stop mate after bishop here? So this is a forced move. Alright, I have to be careful now. I think just pawn here looks pretty good. Pawn here, and yeah, pawn here. Nice. Oh my god, look at this puzzle. So few pieces, but it's probably like so complex. Alright. White to move. The problem with push is that king here, and I think I just lose. So I'm thinking this. But the question is, what's the difference between king b7 and king b5? I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh my god. You just go here and then I lose. I think here is better, because if I go here, I actually block my check. So if I go here, this promotes with check, so I'm gonna go here. And then I'm gonna push this one. So he moved out of the way to like block the check, but I think, I mean, you just lose a tempo. Yeah, so now I just promote to a queen. Let's go. I did it. Oh my goodness, I did it. I quit this game. That feels good. I'm done with this game. All right. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, I thought it'd be fun to just capture and have it on camera because I think it's kind of hilarious. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, feel free to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys soon.